the Trump administration revived the Keystone XL pipeline and began construction after a nearly 13-year delay. Now, the new administration has reversed course. President Biden revoked the permit for the pipeline on his first day in office through executive action, this in the name of climate change.But Nick Loris, an economist who focuses on energy, environmental, and regulatory issues, says this decision is not good for the economy or the environment.
It would have created thousands of construction jobs. It would have safely and reliably delivered oil from our neighbor to the north down to Gulf Coast refineries. And it's the bestenvironmental option for transporting oil. And even the Obama administration, when it was looking at the pipeline, said that the project itself would not contribute significantly to climate change.
Loris notes that with or without the pipeline, the oil will be transported, if not by the pipeline, by rail or truck, which he says is more risky.Loris says the cancellation is also a huge loss for investors. Among them are several Indigenous Canadian groups who collectively invested nearly $764 million in the pipeline. Loris says government action like this makes investors weary of backing infrastructure projects.
But it also results in less efficiency. And so we're not only losing out on the economic development, but we'reLosing out on potentially bringing more efficient resources to the market, which is going to yield better environmental outcomes.
Loris says the key to achieving both economic and environmental progress is investment in new energy sources and rolling back regulations.
If we want the widespread adoption of cleaner energy investment and technologies, we need to make them affordable. And the best way to do that is by really getting the government out of the way, and through market forces.
Loris says that not only fossil fuels, but also renewable energy projects face erroneous regulations.
This is kind of a systemic frustration among all energy sources. And the more we can have regulatory efficiency, the more we can have free trade, and the more we can encourage innovation in new technologies.
He says this will benefit not only the U.S., but also the rest of the world in achieving environmental and economic prosperity. Grace Coulter, NTD News, New York.